Well, as we mentioned earlier in the newscast, Korea marks 71 years of national police service on this Friday. Although the Korean people have enjoyed safety under the country's strong law enforcement authorities for many decades, times are changing and the police force are becoming smarter using state-of-the-art technology. You might have seen them on TV shows, but watch them in real action. Korea's crime scene investigation team. Our news feature tonight with Kim Jung-soo.
The Korean National Police Agency celebrated its 71st birthday in style with a lively ceremony in Seoul's Gwanghwamun Square. Several of the agency's key divisions, including cybersecurity, traffic control and neighborhood patrol, proudly showcased their latest gadgetry. But it was the Korea Crime Scene Investigation Team, a unit that usually operates out of the spotlight, that attracted the biggest fanfare.
Korean society is becoming more and more complex thanks to the developments in science and technology, but the country's criminal landscape is also expanding. That means the police must also equip themselves with the latest state-of-the-art technology.
One of the KCSI team's most prized pieces of equipment is its portable forensic lab, which allows investigators to do a preliminary analysis of the DNA samples they collect on site before sending the results back to the main lab for further analysis. The team's senior investigator says such advanced technology helps the KCSI team work more efficiently, no matter where they're called to duty.
The police started implementing basic scientific research in 1948, but the KCSI team in its modern-day form was established only in 2004. Now there are 1,000 KCSI investigators on active duty. We lend our services in all kinds of situations, from petty crimes to national disasters.
The more complex cases, ones involving multiple homicides or explosions at petrochemical plants, are processed at the KCSI's headquarters, which is equipped with a state-of-the-art crime lab and a facility for analyzing surveillance camera footage.
When we are called to a crime scene, we first make a thorough attempt to collect anything that can tell us about the criminal, which includes fingerprints, strands of hair, or drops of saliva. We then run it through our comprehensive database of personal information.
Although the team had first relied on standard investigative methods and technology from other countries, it's starting to invent its own equipment, including a special infrared flashlight that can be used to identify counterfeit currency and marked gambling cards. Another invention is a specially compressed powder that traces fingerprints without damaging the lungs of the law enforcement agent inhaling it. The KCSI team is even spearheading a project with the Korea International Cooperation Agency to export Korea's cutting-edge investigative technologies to developing countries.
We have countries from all over the world that come to our lab to study and purchase our equipment. Last year, we exported our technology to Papua New Guinea, Guatemala and Honduras.
While it seems apparent that KCSI has become an irreplaceable component of the National Police Force, criminologists say that the division can play an even bigger role in crime fighting as well as crime prevention.
Up to this point, the KCSI team has not been as proactive in policing. I think that with the help of big data analytics, the Korean police force can become even more effective in tackling the problems of today. For example, KCSI and the police can deploy the necessary forces to specific regions that have a strong record of specific crimes in anticipation of future incidents.
As of 2016, there are over 110,000 police officers serving the country, which means one officer is in charge of protecting 452 civilians. Meanwhile, instances of complex fraud and financial crimes have risen by near 70% in the past 5 years. Acknowledging that Korean society faces a new era of challenges, the police agency has stated it will add 20,000 more officers by 2019. Kim Jung-soo, Arirang News.